Good morning, beautiful people. This is Yelena, and today, instead of taking you for a walk, I'm taking you for a drive. We just took our kiddo to school, had a quick teacher-parent conference. So this morning we have the pleasure of having me with makeup on. But today I brought my husband with me. Say hello, darling.
Hello, beautiful people.
We decided to come into your live stream here together, and there's a reason for that. We'll drop into that for a moment here. But before I do that, I wanted to mention a couple of ladies. I just got two notifications over the last 24 hours from women, both of whom were suffering with a Graves condition. One of them, we just started working together less than two weeks ago, and she went from barely moving around, so she couldn't even go for a walk for 10 minutes before she got exhausted. She had to really watch out how her energy was spent. She had to stay home from not being able to work anymore. And as of this last week, just a week and a half into it, she's already moving house, packing and unpacking small boxes. She has energy. The tachycardia is gone. So a major things happened in only 2 weeks. And then we got another notification from a lovely client of ours this morning that my heart was just beating rapidly, that she had such great success, that she was working on reversing Graves' condition for the last 4 to 5 months. And she just got news from her doctor that her medication for Graves was too powerful, too strong, and was driving her thyroid into hypo, which means that she can be medication free. There you go. She was had dealt with Graves' condition for over 5 years, and then she is able to put it into remission in just a matter of about 4 to 5 months. So we're celebrating. I'm celebrating. Are you celebrating?
I'm celebrating. I'm happy. It's fantastic.
So we usually go crazy over stuff like this. I'm like, oh my God.
Don't you see it? We're going crazy.
We're on the way to taking Isabella, our daughter, to school. I'm like, oh my God, look at this. So we're super excited. It's the kind of things that actually make us celebrate what we do and work that much harder. We both work and we run this company together, so the program. So it just gets us super excited because we know what's possible. Yesterday, I spoke with a woman. She gets on a call with me, so we have this two-call process. First one is a pre-qualifier, and next one was when we go deeper. So on this pre-qualifier, I'm talking to this lady, and I said, so why have you waited this long to start addressing it naturally? She said, nobody ever told me it's possible. And she said, I looked through your stuff, and she said, it's still too hard to believe. So it was time for her to get a little bit into a believer.
It's possible, people.
So I sent her several case studies to look at, and she kept just telling. She said, why is it that nobody tells us it's possible to be medication-free eventually? Why is it that people don't tell us and doctors don't tell us that we can reverse this condition? And, of course, the conversation continues. Is most doctors simply don't know. I had heard the same thing over 15 years ago. Hypothyroidism is incurable. Hypothyroidism is irreversible. You cannot conceive naturally. You need medication. You cannot reverse pituitary tumor. So we hear that. Here's the big thing, though. Up until now, well, until recently, just, 15, 20 years ago, it was impossible to do what I'm doing right now. It used to be witchcraft to even think that you can fly. Just imagine that, right? And now people can fly. And now at a click of a button, here you are going on a drive with us right here in Texas while you're in your own state. So things that were impossible had to be conceived as an idea in somebody's head first. So somebody had to say it is possible to cure certain diseases, to get rid of polio. It is possible to, for me, I had to say to myself, and I told my doctor, I said, if it was impossible up until now, I'm going to create that as a reality. And I was so upset. I said, then you can come and study me. That happened. I remember I was one of the first to ever write an article on healing and curing hypothyroidism. It was on my old blog and migrated several times over. And then the government, with its long hand, reached out and told me, if you're going to be doing any programs on your side, you cannot say that you can heal or cure anything. So basically, screw you. We cannot tell people that you can cure or heal yourself. But they're constantly looking for a cure. And I find this dubious on so many levels, because on one hand, they're raising billions of dollars to find a cure. On the other hand, they tell us that we cannot even mention that. And Michelle, hi, Michelle. We're celebrating your success today. Michelle just said, my doctor said that Graves' disease can be cured, but may go into remission. I'm proving him wrong. Absolutely.
That's right. Right.
Somebody on. Had to say first, like it was the Wright brothers, right? We can fly. Let's fall 100 times, but eventually we're flying. Somebody had to say we can fly to the moon. Now Elon Musk says we're going to fly to Mars. And people are laughing at him. And by now, as a humanity, we should have learned something. Don't laugh at anybody. Because we'll always prove people wrong. So the worst thing and the best thing that actually somebody can do to us, to us and you, is to tell us it's impossible because there's a fighter inside of all of us, the Wonder Man or the Wonder Woman. We are going to rise and there's a need in us to prove them wrong. And so it is that fighter in you that can prove your doctors wrong. But at the same time, prove yourself right. The deep desire inside of you that says, well, maybe, just maybe, because Michelle said I'm going to prove him wrong, maybe I'll prove my doctor wrong. There's only one thing that you need to do, is that desire to make something different. And from that desire, it's the mindset. So the client that I mentioned first, who is only 2 weeks in, she said that, yes, I changed my diet, and that was great. But the biggest thing that she said is, I changed my mindset. Mm-hmm. And as she changed her mindset, what has happened is the impossible became possible. She had over 50% improvement in her symptoms in less than 2 weeks when she reported in. So what we're here to tell you is impossible is possible. Yes?
Yes, absolutely.
Why don't you tell them about your impossible? Remember, so my husband here had me. We're back online here. My husband had 3 brain surgeries. And the doctors told us that it would be impossible for him to live without a shunt. And the shunt is basically a tube that would have gone from his brain down into his stomach to pump extra fluid out because his brain could not reabsorb it. Now, at that time, we were only engaged, and he always says that he was my first client ever.
I was your first client.
Why don't you tell him what happened after that?
Well, I don't have a shunt, number one. Everything's normal. My ventricle closed back up. I'm 100%. I was a miracle to my doctor. He says, you're the first case that I've seen this, I've had experienced this with, because I've never had a client like this before in my life.
Patient, excuse me.
You're the my first patient. So the impossible is possible.
And how did we do it, though? Wasn't it a lot of mindset?
It's a lot of mindset. Anyone who came into the hospital room and says, well, you know, maybe he should get the shunt, we kicked him out. We just visualized not having the shunt, and it happened. And after the brain surgery, I had to go back for 4 years because cysts had been known to reoccur. And for those 4 years, my right ventricle just remained the same size.
No, it kept closing.
Kept on closing. So it's possible. The impossible is possible.
Yeah, so what happened with Dimitri was he was promised that you're going to go have the surgery and you're going to be out. Hi, Natasha. You're going to be out, no time, but then he had an infection because something happened during surgery when he got infected. And after that, they said, there's no way he's leaving this hospital without a shunt. I was in my 20s. I was already a fighter at that time. I said, as long as we're paying the bills, we're going to stay here as long as it takes for him to walk out shunt free.
And so the only thing I have now is a little scar right there, but that's it.
That happened, and they told us, ma'am, that's, I will never forget this, ma'am, we respect your faith, but there was this big but. We've done this for many years, and it's not possible. And we said, why not give it a try? And so, like Dimitri said, he's been shunt free and condition free, no pain, no headaches now
almost 20 years.
So my first client ever.
It works.
It's still there. And this is possible for you. Michelle just typed in and said, mindset is a huge factor. Absolutely.
Yes.
Because not to be redundant, but it was Henry Ford who said that if you think that you can, you're right. And if you think that you can't, you're right too. So if you think that your illness, your disease, your condition is incurable, you're in for a long, long, nasty ride. I spoke with somebody that we spoke over a month ago. Had a conversation with this woman, and I told her that what the possibilities were. Her mind could not get wrapped around the fact that she could, in fact, become symptom-free after 25 years of struggling. And the mindset took over her so much that she couldn't dare to believe to actually take an action to move forward and achieve something different. And so I called her again. I was like, how are you doing? Because I do that with people. Are you ready to change your life yet? And she's like, I don't know. She said, I got used to this life so much that I don't know if I'm ready for anything different, which to me, it is almost painful because I do see women like Michelle and like others free themselves because they put their mind to it. And sometimes it's not without a fight. The old mindset goes, well, it's just easy to go and be miserable, right? And the new mindset is like a baby. It needs to be baby then said, yes, you can do it, right?
Mm-hmm.
When he was going through brain surgery, for him it was different. Like, he was out of it. He's like, you're my brain. You can believe, you can fight.
I was out of it. Completely
out of it. So this is part number two of this conversation. That this way I wanted Dimitri to join us today is you need a support system to succeed. When Dimitri was going through brain surgeries, his brain was not even... didn't have the capacity to fight for himself. He had to have an advocate in me to say, we're going to visualize, we're going to meditate, we're going to focus on this, we're going to pray in spite of all this. And he had to rely heavily on my ability to show up for him as a support system to succeed.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's talk about if I were not there, what would have happened?
I probably would have a shunt. And actually, there was a lady who came to the hospital who visited us who had a shunt, and it actually bulged out of her neck. And I thought to myself, I don't want that at all. I actually don't want that in me.
But you have advocacy, and advocacy comes in many forms, ladies. It can be your spouse. So to have a supportive spouse or a supportive partner, boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever they are, is extremely important. Here's what we find, and I've done this for a long time, that women who have a good support system will heal at much faster rate than the ones who do not. If you have a support system and it is your responsibility to recruit your family, your children, your spouse to be a support system to you, if you do, then it is much easier to make changes and you can check in with them with mindset. But that's why also if you don't have it at home, you need a coach. Do not try to do it alone because discouragement will come. So those of you who have worked with me or are working with me now, you ladies know you will go through detox. You will go through when your flesh says, oh my God, I want that piece of cake. And Elena says, let's skip it. And you need somebody to reach out to, and you need somebody to call you out on your BS, and you need somebody to be there strong for you. You need that. So whether it's a coach, a mentor, whether it's a spouse or a family, you need a support system around you. Very few of us can do it on our own. So I was born with a personality that I actually don't give it a living flip or a care in the world what people think, what temptations are out there. My life is black and white. It's either yes or no, that's it. Now other people, they need sometimes the in-between. Wouldn't you agree?
Yes.
Because sometimes when you have a weakness, my husband has a weakness for sweet stuff.
I do. Serious issue.
Yeah, so you need somebody to be there for you during your weakness sometimes to call you out on it.
Absolutely.
You're not going to beat me up after this.
No, absolutely not. I do have a weakness. No. It's the truth.
But you need people on your side. So, Natasha, you said that you're going through the same with Hashimoto's. This is exactly the steps that you want to create for yourself. Create a community around you. And by the way, I posted the link in the description of this video right over there where you can go ahead and schedule a clarity call with me or one of my team members to see what's possible. Because if Michelle can start reversing and put Graves into remission within 5 months after over 5 years having it, and then we talked about another client of ours who shall remain nameless for now in 2 weeks, and then we have tens and tens of case studies on our website. If they could have done it, there's absolutely no reason on this planet for you not to be able to do it. What you need to do is instead of chasing your symptoms or medications or supplements, you need a clear understanding of what is making you sick. And usually there are a lot of factors, but most common ones are diet deficiencies. It could be something with your genetics. It could be stress. It could be trauma. It could be things that you are taking like medications or supplements. It could be your sleep. It could be a lot of other factors going all the way down to your childhood. We noticed that about 70 to 80% of our clients who have autoimmune conditions have had trauma in their life, whether it's neglect, emotional abuse, physical abuse, sexual abuse. It is a precursor to a lot of autoimmune conditions. So those are the things that we look for. Natasha, you said, I'm in remission, took 20 years to catch on. Absolutely, congratulations. If you're in remission and you're symptom-free, congratulations. It can be done, ladies. It should be done. Please do not spend the rest of your life putting up with all the crap that's been given to you, whether you participated in it or not.
As I'm listening to you, I'm thinking you were told you would have hypothyroidism for the rest of your life.
Yes.
You cured that. I was told I would have a shunt in my head.
And we were told we could not have a baby naturally.
We could have a baby. So we're defying the odds of everything that's been
I don't think that we're defined as what I think we're doing, and maybe we can squish in closer together. I think what we're doing is we're redefining what the possibilities are. Because somebody has to say, it is possible. Mm-hmm. Right? Somebody has to pioneer it. So my article was one of the first ones that I wish I had kept the old blog. It was on one of those free platforms. And it was written, 10 years ago. And it was like the dam got open, and now there are articles upon articles. Somebody has got to say, so there's something energetic in this universe, whether it's a universe or God you believe in, but somebody has to be the first. And after there's a pioneer, it is heaven and hell opens up. Not hell, heaven.
Heaven. The positive.
It opens up and it releases all the blessings upon this humanity. So somebody has to say, it's possible, rise up and do it. And it comes down to the mindset. It comes down to healing the trauma. So Natasha, you said 16 years sexual trauma here. Yes, absolutely.
Oh, man.
So we see this mm-hmm. over and over and over again. If there was any emotional, sexual, physical trauma in your life, it is very likely that that was the trigger. Now pile up on that bad diet, bad mindset, some kind of deficiency. And now you're walking, talking, possibility of developing multiple autoimmune conditions, multiple conditions overall. So we need to go in. There is a time and place for talk therapy, but we find often that it does not work because the trauma is stored in your physical body and you need a way to release that and then to rewrite your neural pathways as opposed to going and living in that trauma over and over again. We need to disconnect you from your pain. When that happens, the body heals really fast. I repeat this example that I have over and over again, but it was so stark that I have to share it. 2 years ago, I had a client. She came to me and she was struggling with a lot of symptoms. 4 weeks in, I used to have only a 2 months program at that time. 4 weeks in, so 50% of program done, and she's only 20% better. And we're like, it has to be more than this. Something else is going on. So many conversations later, we find out that she had sexual trauma during her childhood. It was repetitive, and it really damaged her. We gave her the tools. So I don't do talk therapy, but we gave her the tools to address it. In the next 4 weeks, 80% better. When I checked in with her last year, she was 100% better because she had the tools to address that trauma, to get better, to start living. Once the trauma was addressed, the body began to release symptoms. And even things like she had severe hair loss, the hair began to grow back in. So all of those things are interconnected. You are not a compilation of separate body parts. You are a symphony of things that work together, wouldn't you agree? Your mind, absolutely. Your spirit, your kidneys, your liver, mm-hmm. everything works together.
It's a whole unit.
Yeah. So today, if we can leave you with this one thought, that everything, absolutely everything, is curable.
Incurable, yeah.
Everything is possible. Everything is undoable. Everything, there's nothing, unless you are dead and you're 6 feet under, there is still time to have the life you want. Natasha, you said 7 doctors, hundreds of meds, and 20 years later, off of all meds, eat proper, meditate, yoga, humbleness. It's possible. Change your mind to change your life. Amen, amen, and amen to
that. Listening to you talk, I think the ultimate disease that we have is getting over this mindset.
Oh my God.
Things are physical. I understand things are physical, but I think here, between the ears is something, once we program that, the rest of the body just falls in line.
Yeah, two things. So I believe that at the end of the day, we don't have multiple diseases. There's no such things like cardiovasculars and cancers and Hashimoto's and all the other. It's one disease. It's a disease of poor nutrition and poor mind. That's it. The rest of the things that we're experiencing that we're calling diseases, those are actual symptoms. Because the same triggers can create cancerous outbreak in one person, and another person it could be had high cholesterol and chest pains and angina. In another person, in me, it led to me having hypothyroidism, and somebody else's Hashimoto's, somebody else's Graves, and somebody else's something else. But the beginning of it all is really stressful, poor mindset and lifestyle, and really horrible diet. When those two go hand in hand, the hell will wreak havoc. But the good stuff is everything is curable. Everything is changeable. And you can absolutely flip the right switch on. The body can create, and I'm gonna tie up with this. The body and your mind are so powerful that they can create a pharmacy on demand in your body. There was a study done in Japan. So write this one down. I don't remember the name, but I can post and share it. But they took 13 men who had a reaction to poison ivy. So it's known if they had contact with poison ivy, they would have a horrible reaction to it, so allergic reaction. And well, here's what they proposed in the study. They took two different leaves. One was from poison ivy plant, the other one from a regular tree, so not poisonous. They blindfolded the men, and on one arm they rubbed them in with a regular tree leaf, on the other with poison ivy leaf. When they applied the regular tree leaf, they said this is a poison ivy plant, and all 13 of them without exception broke out in hives and welts. It was not a poisonous plant. Now they take the poison ivy plant and they rub it another arm when they're saying this is a regular tree leaf, and 11 out of 13 have zero reaction to it. Only two broke out in hives. So please explain it to me. It was nothing but
between the ears.
Is the heart, the body-mind connection that created that. There's a really well-known story of a guy that was called Mr. Wright. Not his actual name, but in 1957, he had tumors and he was given a very short time to live. And there was some kind of horse something, I can't remember, some kind of basically medication that was, he was told that that would help him cure the disease. He got the injection from his doctor, and all of a sudden, these tumors are melting away like ice on heat. And then he read an article in a newspaper that it's actually a hoax and it's not supposed to work, and all of a sudden his symptoms began to come back. And the doctor decided, well, if it was his mind to start with, let's do it again. So he gives him saline water and says, well, this is double strength of that medication. It is really known to help. He injects him and this guy is back to normal again. The tumors are melting away. He's doing fine. A couple of months later, he reads an article that now it has been absolutely proven that this medication is a hoax. Two days later, this guy dies. His mind, his expectations were able to heal him very quickly and also kill him very quickly, because he was given no more hope at one point, and he took that hope away from him rather than realizing, I created this wellness inside of me. And there are numerous examples just like this. So we know what's possible. And if you need help getting there, there's a link above this video. Click on it, schedule a call, it costs you nothing. We'll talk about possibilities. But right now, just stop telling yourself, everything is curable. My disease is curable. It is possible to be symptom free. It's possible to be medication free. It's possible to be happy in a marriage. Even if you've been married for
almost 20 years.
He's playing it safe. He does that. Like,
yes, almost 20 years.
Almost 20 years. So it's all possible. And if anything today, I want you to wish that mindset. Everything is curable. With that, ladies, thank you so much for joining me on this little rant of ours. Have a fantastic
day. Talk to you later.
We'll talk to you later.